Why can't she spin herself? What's her angular momentum? Zero. What's the system? Her. So you would have to have some external torque to make her spin. No, I'm not going to push you. I mean, I am going to hand you something that is rotating very quickly. Okay? This is a motor. Wait, how do I use it? There's a motor right here, and I'm going to make this bike wheel. What's the angular momentum of this bike wheel right now?
Zero.
Oh my God, I love you guys. Next quarter is going to be so lame when I'm not teaching. Okay. And I'm going to spin it up. So this is going to spin, and it's going to make this spin up. And then it's going to have angular momentum. And then I'm going to hand it to Kate. And then Kate is going to move it. And even though the actual velocity of this doesn't change, the direction of the angular momentum of this is going to change as she moves it. And then she's going to start spinning. Or maybe that's what's going to happen. I don't know. I've never seen this demo. Okay. And also, for the record, I'm really bad at demos. And I'm kind of scared of PHYS. Oh, here. Both hands.
Okay.
Okay. Good job not falling down. No, now move it down. And it stopped her, and now she's running out of her.
Oh.
What? The bike fall down. Just saying. Unless you're me. And then you get hit by a car. And then you fall down. Yes.
Why wasn't she moving when the bike wheel was held perpendicular?
Because she didn't start moving and the angular momentum was in this direction, perpendicular to her ability to spin. That's a good question. Okay. So now we're all gonna do something. Okay, I'm gonna spin you. Is that okay? And you're gonna smack me. No, here, hold them out. So I'm gonna. Okay, now.
Oh.
And now out. And now in. And then it's MR squared. Yeah? Okay. Thank you, Kate.
Thank you.